Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit and these are the major news stories of the day. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has inaugurated the new parliament building in the national capital today. He also installed the historic Sengol near Lok Sabha Speaker's chair in the parliament. Tension gripped in New Delhi as top wrestlers including Vinesh Fogat and Sakshi Malik were detained by Delhi police while attempting to march towards the new parliament building. Tamil Nadu Forest Minister Dr. M. Madhivendan said that the wild tusker Arikomban has retreated into the inner forests of Meghamalai. In the sensational Kerala hotelier murder case, key evidence including an electric cutter have been recovered. The crew of Norwegian vessel, which was detained by the Nigerian authorities last year on suspicion of crude oil piracy, has been released after court dropped charges against them. Let's get into the details. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Sunday inaugurated the new parliament building in the national capital. He installed the historic Sengol near Lok Sabha Speaker's chair today morning in the parliament. The scepter was reportedly handed over to the then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru as the British left the country. Opposition leaders have questioned the authenticity of the Sengol while boycotting the inaugural. Union Ministers Rajnath Singh, Amit Shah, S. Jaishankar and Jitendra Singh, the chief ministers of several states and BJP President J.P. Nadda were present on the occasion. Thousands of police personnel have been deployed in Luthi and Delhi and multiple layers of barricades put in place as part of the security arrangement in and around the new parliament building, officials said. Tension gripped the national capital when the Delhi police tried to restrict and detain protesting wrestlers at Jantar Mantar who broke the barricades and began to march towards the new parliament today. Police detained wrestlers Sakshi Malik and Vinesh Fogat in the incident. Amid the inaugural functions of the new parliament building, the sportspersons held Mahila Mahapanchayat in front of the new complex. Police had denied permission to hold any such protest at the venue. The wrestlers have been staging a protest in Delhi demanding the arrest of Wrestling Federation Chief and BJP MP Brij Bhushan Sharan Singh, who they say harassed and sexually exploited women wrestlers. Meanwhile, wrestler Vinesh Fogat raised sharp criticism against the centre over the Delhi police's action against protesting wrestlers ahead of Mahila Mahapanchayat in front of the new parliament building. Tamil Nadu Forest Minister Dr. M. Madhivendan has informed that the wild tusker Arikomban has retreated into the inner forests of Meghamalai. The elephant has now ventured 1.5 kilometres into the forest, the minister informed. A team from the forest department is on site to monitor the elephant. The minister had arrived in Kambam and assessed the arrangements made by the forest department. The department had launched Mission Arikomban on Sunday morning after the government issued an official order to capture and relocate the tusker. The investigation team probing the gruesome murder of Siddiq Mecheri, a hotelier from Kerala, has recovered key evidence including the victim's clothes and materials used for evidence destruction that would turn crucial in providing the role of three youths arrested in the case. While Siddiq's chopped up body parts were recovered from Attapadi on May 26, a week after he was murdered in cold blood at a hotel in Kozhikode, the accused disposed his clothes, the electric cutter used to cut the body into three parts, the other evidence at Cheerattamala, a sparsely populated tourist port located 5 kilometres from Angadipuram, a major suburb of Perinthalmanna town. The investigation team led by Malappuram Police Chief S. Sujit Das took the accused, Shibali, Farhana and Ashik towards Angadipuram. The cops also collected evidence from an ATM counter from where the trio withdrew money. The crew of the Norwegian vessel MT Heroic Iden, which was detained by the Nigerian authorities last year on suspicion of crude oil piracy, has been released after a court dropped charges against them. 16 of the 26 crew members of the vessel were Indians and 3 among them Malayalis. Others were from Poland, Philippines and Sri Lanka. The Nigerian authorities have returned the passports of the crew members as per sources. It is not clear as to when they would reach home. The release comes after the months-long trial in a Nigerian court. There has been pressure on Nigeria at an international level, pointing out that the ship and the crew have been framed and detained. Kochi natives Chief Officer Captain Sanu Jose, Milton D. Koth and Kollam native V. Vijit are the Keralites among the crew. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose hosted by me, Swati Ajit. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Murlitharan with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.